In this video, I'll show you how to create file download button. First of all, I'll show you how to create that download file button with the help of HTML code. With just one line of HTML code, you can add this functionality, but there are certain limitations. And later on, we'll add the same functionality with the help of JavaScript code. So I'll be showing you two methods. What are the limitations? Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsar with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. See, pop up. So I have already created the download.html file, and inside that file, let's hit exclamatory sign and tab button, then you'll get this basic HTML code. So now let's give the title. For the title, I'm giving download file button. Now let's go inside the body tag and let's create anchor tag. So inside the same folder, I do have another folder images. And inside that folder, you can see different images. So with the help of HTML code, we'll download this js.png file. For the href attribute, I'm giving the file location. So I'm writing images/js.png. Okay, in order to download, in order to give another attribute, that is download. For now, let's give just only download. Inside the anchor tag, I'm writing download. If you have installed the live server extension in the VS code, then inside the any HTML file, if you right click and hit the option called open with live server, then it will open it in your default browser. So it's a very little CSS code, so I'm using internal CSS. So just below the title tag, I'm creating a style tag, and inside the style tag, for the inverter selector, I'm giving margin of 0, so it will prevent the default browser's margin. For the body tag, I'm giving height of 100 VH. Similarly, let's give display flex, justify content to center, and also align items to center. So with the help of this code, all the content of your body tag will bring it to the center. So now let's style that anchor tag. For the anchor tag, I'm giving background color of lime. For the color, let's give white color. And also I'm giving padding. For the padding top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem, and for the left and right, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's give some border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 0.5 rem. Now let's remove that underline. So in order to remove that underline, I'm giving text decoration to none. Okay, now we can see button is looking a bit good. Similarly, let's give the download icon. Okay, so for the download icon, I'm giving the HTML entity. Okay, you can see that's a special character. So inside the anchor tag, I'm creating span with class name download. And inside that, I'm giving HTML entity. For that, I'm writing ampersand down arrow bar and semicolon. Don't forget to give that. So that will give you that download icon. Similarly, for the body tag, let's give font. For the font width, I'm giving 600. For the font size, I'm giving 1.2 rem. And for the font family, I'm giving sans serif. Okay, now it's looking a bit good. Similarly, let's give some space between the download and that download icon. So for that, let's copy this download class. Let's paste and let's give some font size. For the font size, I'm giving 2 rem, and also let's keep some margin. For the margin right, I'm giving 1 rem. Okay, now there is some space between that download and the download icon. So now when you click that button, you can see pop-up window appears. You can see the same file name that you have given the location for the anchor tag. So if you hit the save, you can see js.png file has been downloaded. So if you want to change that file name, if you want to give custom file name, then for the download attribute, you can give your custom name. Did you see that? Custom name.png. So if you want to give the custom name, then you can give some value for the download attribute. So I'll show you the proof that file was downloaded. So if I go to the download folder, and you can see there are two files, js.png and custom name.png. So these two attributes are very necessary. So you can see href and the download. So with the help of that download attribute, you can download the file. So you are downloading the file, but you need to give the location. So for that, in the href attribute, you will be giving the file's location, and with the help of that download attribute, you will be able to download the any file that is within your this HTML file. If the location of the file is not within the HTML file, then it won't download. Okay, so this is what the limitation of this code. Okay, you can see in the same folder we have PDF file. So let's download this PDF file. So in the href attribute, I'm passing the PDF file. This is state management.pdf file, and also for the download attribute, let's give custom PDF. In the browser, if you click that button, you can see custom pdf.pdf, and if you press that save button, okay, now you can see we have downloaded that PDF file. So in the same folder, you can see index.html file. So I'll open it in the browser with the help of live server. You can see this live text editor. So if I give the background color to lime, you can see there is live update. I have already created the separate video for this live code editor. Video's link will be in the description below, so you can check it out. So now inside the David class name HTML code, let's copy this whole code and let's paste it. So we don't need this code, so let's remove. And also let's remove this href and download attribute. We don't need this. You can see that at the top download icon. So now let's copy this code in the standard CSS file. Let's paste it. We want only the font size, so let's take it at the top. And also we don't need this code, so let's remove. Similarly for the padding for top and bottom, I'm giving 0. For the left and right, there is more padding, so let's give 1.2 rem. Similarly, let's give float right in the browser. Now you can see that button with download icon. So when you press that button, now you have to download something. So you can see I have already linked the JavaScript file. Let's go to the JavaScript file. I have already selected the anchor tag. This anchor tag, okay. So when you hit that download button, we'll create the HTML file and we'll download all this code, okay. This HTML code, CSS code, and also the JavaScript code. So in order to do that, I'm creating separate variable let data is equal to, so this backtick. So in your keyboard, just above the tab button, you can get it. So inside that backtick symbol, let's copy this whole code. Let's paste it. We don't need the CSS code. Let's remove this all the code. We don't need this anchor tag, so let's remove this anchor tag. Similarly, inside the style tag, you can give CSS code that is the variable. So in order to access that variable, you can give dollar parentheses, and inside that you can write CSS code dot value. So with the help of this code, you will be able to get the CSS code. Also for the HTML code, inside that body tag, we are doing the same thing. Let's write dollar parentheses and HTML code dot value. So this code will help you to access the HTML code. Similarly for the JavaScript code, first of all, let's create the script tag, and inside the script tag, we are doing the same thing. Inside the dollar parentheses, I'm giving JS code dot value. So this all the codes are stored in the data variable. Now this is our data. Now you need to download this data. So how can you download that? In order to download, first of all, let's create the blob object. So inside the blob variable, I'm storing the blob object. So I'm writing new blob, and inside that, for the first parameter, you need to give the data. So that data you need to pass inside the array, so this data. And for the second parameter, it will take the object. It is not that necessary, you know, like you may or may not give the second parameter, but I want to give key type, and for the value I'm giving, so whatever the file type you have, you can give that type of file. Okay, so you can give something like text/html, or if that's the CSV file, you can give text/CSV, but that should be in a string, but I'm giving octet string. So it will accept the all the file types, like binary file types. Similarly, after creating the blob object, now you need to create the URL. So I'm writing let URL is equal to URL. So these all are in capital. Okay, dot create object URL, and within that method, I'm passing that blob variable. Now with the help of this two line of code, or the shortened URL is generated. something like this. You can see there's some blob protocol, and at the end you can see the unique ID. So it will help you to store your data or the file in the your system's memory. In the first method, I have already shown you that we need that as ref and also the download attribute. So I'm writing object.assign. So for the first parameter, you will give the target. So for the target, I am giving anchor tag.a. This A, and for the second parameter, I'll pass the object. For the href, I'm giving URL. So that means with the help of that code, you'll be able to give the href attribute for the anchor tag, something like this. And instead of that URL, let's change that variable name to href. Now you can remove that URL. You can give just href. So if the object's key and the value, they have the same common name, then you don't need to give, you know, double time. So now you can write just href. So for the download, I'm giving custom html.html. So this code will be executed only when you click that anchor tag, okay? I mean, like when you click that button. So I could write a.onclick. I'm assigning error function. Now instead of that error function, let's give the function, and instead of that a, you can change it to this. So this refers to that anchor tag, okay? So now when you click that download button, now you can see that custom html.html file. So when you hit that save button, now you can see you're downloading that file. So I have already downloaded this custom html.html file. So if I open it in the Sublime Text Editor, now you can see inside that file, we have all this code, okay? So this code was downloaded, and also we have created this separate file. But if you are using the like library such as Axios, then you could use something like axios.get, or you can use this fetch API. So for the first parameter, you could give something like URL of your file, and for the second, like you could give the method get, and in response, you could pass, like instead of that data, you could pass the response. So this is also the other way, you know, like in the real time, like you could use this kind of thing. So yeah, this is really cool. I have already told you that data was stored in the memory of your system. You know, in order to free up that memory space, you could write url.revoke object URL, and inside that you could pass href. So with the help of this code, you can free up that memory space. Let's take it at the bottom and let's cut it, and inside the set timeout function, so within 0.5 seconds, that data will be removed from your memory. So you can see for the time period, it is better to give more time, because if your file size is big, then definitely it would take more time to download. So I'm giving 9000, that means 9 seconds. So within that 9 seconds, the data that is stored in your memory, that would be removed. If you want to free up your memory space, then this code is necessary, otherwise this code is not that necessary. When you hover that download button, you can see at the bottom this kind of URL is automatically generated. So with the help of that URL and the blob API, so which help you to download any kind of file. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it, and also be sure to hit that subscribe button. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.